A very good morning to you. It is Tuesday, Entrepreneurship Tuesday, here on Y in the Morning, only on Y254 channel. This is your favorite breakfast show, and my name is Hilda Wadidi, and it's about time we talk to some young people in studio. And to start us off on Entrepreneurship Tuesday, we have brought people who are producing films, people from the entertainment industry. They go by Black Ink Frames. Gosh, I don't know what I said
Black
today.
Ink Films.
Okay. Anyway, if you do want to participate in the conversation, do slide into our DM at 254 channel on Twitter. The hashtag is Y in the Morning, hashtag Entrepreneurship Tuesday. On Facebook, we're at Y254. On Instagram, Y254 underscore channel. On DSTV, 376, star times 54, signet 824. So make sure you do keep it here. So Black Ink Frames. Finally, now it has come out properly.
Yes, films.
Yes. Let us meet some of the director and the producer. I have Omboy Ngombo here with me. I have Sunday Lion. But let them say good morning to you first.
Hi, guys. Mm-hmm. My name is Omboy. I'm the producer for Black Ink Films. Mm-hmm. Hilda said it rings, but it films.
Please, we see the shaker today. Today is tough morning.
Yeah, and we're here to talk about film production and the entertainment industry, basically.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, I go by the names of Ivan Sunday, aka Sunday Lion, and I'm primarily the director for the production house. Yes.
Okay, so Black Ink, you told me that you guys founded this thing 3 years ago, and I'd like to know how you guys met. Where did you guys fall in love with film and then decide, oh, let's create this team, let's do this? When did this begin?
You'll answer it.
I'll answer it. Yeah. I don't think it happened how you think it happened. We were friends before. We knew we were film producers. So yeah, the friendship was built a long time ago. Then by chance we fell in love with film. We took film, we went to film school differently. And then was it in 2017?
Yeah, 2016 2017.
Yeah, we were at a party and then we were like, guys, so you just come together because you're doing the same thing and form this thing. And yeah, that's how it happened.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, I'll tell the gist of the story.
Yes, I'm here.
So by that time, I think she was working as an editor for a TV program in one of the media stations. And I was just from a project as a cinematographer for an NGO. And we were sitting together after a long, you know, work day. And they told me about Black Ink and how passionate they were in. And I decided, let's just formalize this. We went and got registered. And yeah, we've been kicking ever since. Yeah, so it was primarily a group of friends that were, all of them were doing in film in different avenues. So the idea of it being a collaborative pact and it working as such just came to us in a click. And we ran with it. We just did it 3 years down the line.
Okay, so tell me about your first project together.
Wow.
First project together was for an event. It's called, it was, I don't know if it's still there, it's called Millennials Village.
It is still there, yeah.
So what happened is I knew one of the organizers was my roommate, but I was not really interested. So this guy calls me, he's like, yo, we need to have portfolio. See, you get this gig. So I talk to those guys, I'm like, I'll give you an after movie. But I need tickets for free. Hey, they're like, you know, people are opportunists. They just want tickets for free.
But you're going to use your camera and equipment.
They rented. So I was like, I told my team, being the producer, that we will contribute this and this amount. They'll give us two tickets. We went four people. And then the other two, we will buy for ourselves. So that's what we did. And then we went, we did a very nice after movie. It was very nice, actually. And then our table stand.
The project we did, let's say it was because we sat down and you were like, and I told them, okay, we have a good team, but we are not out there, so people do not know exactly the new formation we have made. And by that time I knew a couple of the organizers that were doing the event. So I reached out and she reached out to her contact. So initially they were like, we've never heard of you guys, you know, we're not sure. Then I was like, okay, I trust in my brand, I trust in my people, and if you want to trust in us, let's work together. If you don't want to work with us, it's okay. And I think coming out that firm made them consider like maybe these people have something to offer. So they gave us tickets, and actually it ended up being the networking event that now brought Black Ink into fruition. We ended up getting jobs with high-end clients. Mm-hmm. We worked with a school in Wilson.
Oh,
yeah. Uh-huh. They were doing an aviation project, mm-hmm. for on a quarterly basis, every, mm-hmm. 3 months. Mm-hmm. We ended up doing it. We're having some sort of contract for the whole year,
mm-hmm.
Which was good for the company. You know, securing such a deal at the beginning, mm-hmm. of your company, it was huge, and we were able to grow and. It boosted the confidence for us as a production house, and we knew that we were able to deliver what we had planned to do.
Yeah. So what's harder, getting started or maintaining?
I would say getting started is not hard at all,
mm-hmm.
because it is something that comes internally.
Mm-hmm.
Most people already know that they want to start.
Mm-hmm.
But the affirmation of continuation, that you should continue,
mm.
Especially when things now become tough.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And the hardest thing for us was now collaborating as a team, you know, because yeah, alikuwa na CV yake mzito, mia niko na CV yangu mzito. Our other director is called Augustine Bai. Yes, he wasn't, yes. able to make it today, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But he also had his own things he had done.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a matter of now let's think together, because,
mm-hmm.
it's the first initiative is I have my work cut out for me. This is how I do things,
mm-hmm.
and this is how I do things. So getting, first of all, some sort of routine that, mm-hmm. would sync us together took a bit of time.
Mm-hmm.
Then when that came, communication, you know, how do you communicate? You're so used to doing things on your own.
Mm-hmm.
If someone wants to talk to Sunday Lion.
Yes, yes. I'd really like yeah. to also understand from Wamboi, mm. now that kila mtu alikuja na CV yake mzito, and now you are in a team and now you have to work together. And what was your experience like?
I've always, I think I'm a leader.
Sounds
very egotistic.
Me too.
Yeah, I'm a leader. So I've been bringing people together since a while back. So it's not hard for me, uh-huh. to work in a team.
Mm-hmm.
Communication, I wasn't that bad.
Mm-hmm.
I knew that if you're working in a team, mm-hmm. especially when there's like two guys and I'm the only chick, there's a certain way like you have to communicate.
Mm-hmm.
And I tried to involve them at least. Since we became a team, I made sure every project I was doing, they were involved.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think alone you can go far,
mm-hmm.
but together, yeah. you can go further. So like, I've always believed in teamwork.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think we've found our way around communication. We're not having those,
yeah.
issues anymore.
Those were beginner problems.
Oh, they don't exist anymore.
No.
Okay. So yeah. Let's talk about your individual training. Just in case somebody is interested in venturing into this particular route of work, what experience do you guys have? Because I can hear somebody here was producing a TV program somewhere. What training did you go to? Which schools? Which schools? Even you. YouTube, whatever, just let us know.
Mm-hmm. Unfortunately,
mm-hmm.
we did not go to YouTube University, but we've been there recently.
And very unfortunate. You know, maybe someone out there was waiting to be inspired.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, sorry.
We actually went to film school.
Mm-hmm.
I went to Multimedia University.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
and I studied film production and animation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I went to school for this.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a producer.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a video editor,
mm-hmm.
and I'm getting into directing,
mm-hmm.
and before all this I was a photographer,
mm-hmm.
so yeah.
Oh, so you started with photography?
Yeah.
Wow.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because I love photography, and then it reached a point I was like, I love video more.
You diversified into film.
Yeah, film is amazing. So yeah, we went. I went to Multimedia, mm-hmm. together with Augustine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
yeah.
Sandy, what about you?
I went to Africa Digital Media Institute.
Mm-hmm.
You want like the breakdown?
Yes. Excuse me.
So I went to Africa Digital Media Institute,
mm-hmm.
and there I was fortunate enough to be the chairman of the student council, and also chairing in the executive council for the school.
You just had to sneak in the leadership.
You said we do the whole nine yards.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Then I went to Goethe Institute. I did I studied a bit of German.
Mm-hmm.
Then I generally went into a bit of consultancy,
mm-hmm.
working on projects in a contractual. So for example, like the NGO project,
mm-hmm.
I was a consultant, a DMA and a cinematographer.
Mm-hmm.
We were working with around 80 girls with the Shadada project, trying to teach them film. So imagine I came from school to teaching.
Wow.
Yeah, and actually doing a film that is called Atieno that was premiered in Nairobi Cinema and also in Kisumu. From there, then I started doing jobs as a Steadicam operator for Homeboys Entertainment. And there I was able to do I was fortunate enough to work with people like Casper Nyovest, Yemi Alade, Mr. Easy,
Yemi Alade, Chronix, Mr. Yeah, Easy,
Western,
okay,
Kerry Hilson. Should I go?
No. Okay.
Yes, I was I was fortunate enough to work with all these people, and then generally I've also been fortunate enough to work with Black Ink, and under Black Ink we've done projects with the Kenya School of Flying, Brooke International School, we've done Millennials, we've done Barack Jacuzzi and Friends, we've worked with a couple of people in Africa Nouveau, we've done a couple of music videos that are yet to come out and some more that are coming out too. Yes. Oh, I also forgot I was nominated for Zanzibar International Film Festival 2017.
Congratulations.
Yes, and Smartphone Film Competition 2018. Yeah.
Okay, now that we have seen the credentials, the reaction over here, can we talk about some of the challenges that you guys have encountered as a group, especially now that you've been around for long? I'm sure you've had a few challenges. At least we know the communication was a beginner one. So what other challenges can you say that you have faced before we talk about some of your projects?
We've external challenges mostly, like lack of proper funding in the film industry. Like most of the challenges we're experiencing now are not internal, they are mostly external. Yeah, so we can say what you're experiencing right now is the fear of stagnation, what you said, maintaining, like just maintaining the business where it is and growing. Yeah, those are some of the challenges, and also like trying to be out there, you know, like we want people to know about Black Ink. Yeah, and it's not as easy as we thought.
Oh, so getting your brand noticed.
Brand awareness,
and which is interesting because now your Instagram page is over here. And we can see a few photos. I can see more photos than videos. I think we can just scroll down and just have a look at their page. Who are these?
So just random people you take photos of when you're starting off. Yeah, and then when you scroll up, you'll see.
Yeah, there's a couple of videos we started uploading.
Oh,
because part of one thing we are big on is strategy. So we were on it's an Instagram platform. You start creating audiences with your pictures, then you start creating video content.
Okay.
That's why most of the things you're seeing beginning are pictures.
So it's gradual. It's very gradual.
It's very gradual,
I like your logo. I like the eye.
Wow.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's talk about your best project, the best one, the one that you can say, in overall, the 3 years, you're like, yes, now this Black Ink, your favorite one.
Our best project is the one we're going to do next.
Oh, so what do you think? can we get a small hint?
Actually, for us, that's our motto. Every time we do a project, we say the best has not yet been done. It's a gradual increase. It's an improvement. So we have done good projects, but we are yet to do our best one. And the when we do the best one, we'll do the best and the best, so we keep on increasing.
Okay, so now that you've mentioned that the best one is yet to come, what can we expect from Black Ink?
Fire, just expect
fire. Yeah, but, I like that answer came out.
For 2019, Black Ink is big on collaborations. So you would see Black Ink collaborating with other production houses, which is something very rare in the Kenya entertainment scene. You'll see Black Ink cooperating with other actual production houses. You'll see us collaborating with corporates. We actually have a commercial coming out very soon. You'll see brand awareness, what you're doing now. You'll see hopefully more of Black Ink on your TV screens, in a different channels, different programs. So this is part of our strategy, actually, for 2019. Just to create brand awareness and collaborate. That's our plan for the year.
And also, we have a short web series coming soon. So we want to be also out there as film producers this year. So that's something I think you forgot to mention, and it's actually something.
Actually, we're doing a web series, and we're doing, I think, two films. There are two films coming out
from Black Ink.
Short films. Yeah. Exciting. I'll make sure I keep tabs with that, because I also used to do film at some point and then I stopped. So let's talk about some of the trending things in your industry. as people who have credentials, you've studied it, and then there's this other group of people that went to YouTube to school. Can you say that there's any clash, especially when it comes to getting jobs? Do you feel like it even mattered that you went to school or it doesn't?
Can I take that?
Yeah.
It's okay.
My issue with the YouTube university people is not the skill, actually. It's the budgeting side, right? Because when you go to film school, you're taught how to make a proper budget for production.
Oh.
How to plan writing production schedules, keeping, even writing presentations, writing proposals. And most YouTube channels will just teach you how to shoot, primarily.
Mm-hmm.
And I would say, from interest, there is no problem with YouTube learning.
Mm-hmm.
You could learn from interest.
Mm-hmm.
A bit, so that when you go to school, you have a stepping stone. But the thing is, every time you think about it, you are going to interact with people who are learned. If you are thinking about this in the bigger picture, so how will they view you, and your education? So it's pretty important also for verification. People feel safer, especially if you want to go the corporate world. People feel safer if you want to look for funding, if you want to collaborate with governments. People feel safer when you have credentials. It's like, it's not more or less like you are qualified, it's more or less like you have taken, you have invested something in it, you have put in money in it. So I can trust you with putting money in you. But when you do YouTube, no offense, but it's bundles. So someone is like, you want me to give you a budget of 5 million, and all you did to learn this is 5 minutes on YouTube.
And
also how they budget, and the conflict comes in with how they budget for clients. Like, you find I've written a proper quotation that will do a proper production, but for this guy anafikiria, if I have 10,000 I can go out this weekend, so they'll just ask for you understand the proper cost of production, versus what they do. So clients will feel like, I need to go with these YouTube guys because they're cheap and all that.
But also, just to state, most people who go to YouTube are people who are interested in being crew.
Yes.
And not people who are trying to do a business.
Mm-hmm.
And Black Ink is trying to do a business.
Okay.
Black Ink wants to collaborate even with the Y24.
We want to get some paper.
Exactly. We want to be the decision makers. We want to make the decisions, be in the boardrooms. And that requires you to have credentials. So it was very strategic for all of us to get credentials, because that is the bigger picture of Black Ink. We want to extend not only in the region, but in Africa, and also be able to collaborate abroad.
Let's talk about, there's a very sensitive topic that I almost forgot about. Risky content. What would you say is risky content for Black Ink? You know, we are having a lot of issues when it comes to homosexuality, LGBTQ. What do you define as risky content? Like this is a no-go zone, or can you actually do it if you had the chance?
I think as a creative, you never have risky content, because your mind wanders.
Has an audience. That's why there are some contents that there's an industry I don't want to mention in Hollywood that exists primarily for that risky content. But also it's more or less in terms of your objective and how you want to be seen as a brand. Sometimes we actually will turn down projects if we feel that it doesn't represent Black Ink the way it should.
Have been in a position where you had to turn
We usually say no most times before we say yes, because we are three, understand the dynamics, and before we can get a go on something, we have to all see on the interests of Black Ink, not on the interest of Sunday Lion or on Grace or on Stain Gatuma. It has to be on the interest of Black Ink as an entity. So that in mind keeps us in check, that even if we may not agree in terms of the moral ground, it's how do we represent Black Ink as a company.
That's very interesting. I'm surprised that you've actually had an opportunity to turn away some money.
Yes, we have.
We've turned down even opportunities.
Hey.
Yeah, because of how, if you're building a business, there's the long-term goal. Someone said the reason why Africans fail, it's because if you ask an African if they have a five-year goal, most of them don't.
Yes.
And that thing actually hurt me. So we have 5 year goals, we have 10 year goals.
Actually, we have the beginning of the year we did
diversify into something.
Beginning of the year we did we did a strategic plan for the company that goes down up to 10 years. That's why you are hearing.
So mumechipanga until
We are good for a decade.
Okay, I can see some some Diani images running through here. Yes. You can see people having a good time in a swimming pool and stuff. What was happening?
We shot a holiday camp for Kenya School of Flying. And we got to go to Diani.
Kenya School of Flying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, God, so you guys were in choppers?
Yeah, we were in planes.
We were in
They are called Cessnas.
No,
they
actually, are called Cessnas. Actually, no. We fly CC water cockpit.
Yeah, we've been with the pilot. That's how we fly. We fly with pilots.
That's how you roll.
We don't know about passengers.
Okay, so let's talk about what do you feel that the government can do to make your life easier as a film producer?
I don't know if this will put you guys in trouble.
It's okay, go ahead.
I think they should just fire Ezekiel Mutua. That's the first thing. That will solve all our problems.
Moral police by calling for your removal.
Oh. Yeah, that's just it. And I think, you know, like, okay, I'm sorry to say, he should not be in a classification board. And that is one of the problems. By the KFCB and the licensing and all those things, that is where the problem is, right? Because if they made it easier for us to shoot, we can shoot content.
So they should make it easier for you to shoot, especially when it comes to permits and places like that.
The thing is, on a lighter note on fairing, don't come for us, Mr. Mtua. Okay, please do not come for us. But generally, it's out of legislation that you govern an industry. Okay, so you have proper legislation, then you create a regulatory body that then is able to create industry. So we have big problems in the film industry because of legislation and licensing. You get it is sort of unfavoring for a lot of production companies or a lot of SMEs that are trying to venture into the industry of entertainment because of legislation alone. You get. So if I'm going to meet an investor today, they feel, you know, it's, I don't know, the government also has problems with you, or maybe I want to go and get something, and maybe the licensing for it alone is 20,000. You get. And that's even nice. Even shooting in our beautiful CBD, you know, it's hectic. There are not very many aerial views, and the people who've been able to do it have done it in big budget productions. No photography bans on almost all public places. And you know, this is art. Someone wakes up and wants to take a city in the Nairobi, a photo in the Nairobi city, and they can't do that. So what do they have to do? They have to go and maybe go to a balcony outside their house and take the photo there. But maybe that creative individual would have taken a way better picture if they were allowed to be in a creative space. So legislation is a big issue. And also in terms of internally as an industry, we have the challenge of regulation as ourselves, with the guilds and the associations. Primarily, most people don't feel like they are out for the interests of production houses, especially startups, because we have the ones, I don't know, I'm not going to mention, but we have the ones that are doing big budget productions. And you find that in those regulation boards, they are the individuals who are sitting there. So you see,
corruption.
So you see vested interest. How can I be in charge of a guild and I have a production house which is going for the same bids?
Okay. Yeah. So there's an unfair advantage somewhere.
Yeah, there is a big unfair advantage, especially if you want a startup in this industry. Then the issue of, we only trust people who are old. You get.
We only trust people who are old.
Yes, exactly. In our field, that's a big thing, because I go there and I tell someone I am a director. They look at me. They look at my age, which is a big issue. Until then, I start speaking of everything I have done, and then I'm this impressive individual, and they all want to collaborate.
I think that's a problem many young people face everywhere, not only in your industry.
But you see, the thing is, in our industry, people look at experience very much, especially. I'm not talking about the small stuff. I'm talking about the big budget stuff. Someone wants to put in $100 million on a production house. They're not going to look at a 25-year-old. You get.
Oh, I'm sorry, the age thing. Don't worry, it's not just you, it's everywhere. So in the spirit of inspiring the young people, Guy, let us not finish like that. It's about time we end this interview. But as a parting shot, what words of advice or encouragement or even just, I don't know, you should know this, like word on the street, you can let the people at home know?
From my side, I think what I can tell the young guys is just that, keep doing what you're doing. Don't give up. By the way, whatever Sunday is saying, I disagree. I don't feel like it's an issue because I never met a billionaire that was 25. Very few.
Yeah.
These things happen as you keep pushing and keep going.
Yeah.
So in 10 years' time, I'm sure we'll be there.
Yeah.
But for now, you have to keep working, keep pushing. Yeah, these things work out. Actually, it can be done. Yeah, it's amazing when you get to do it.
Thank you, one boy.
Yeah.
Sunday.
Okay, I'm the strategist, so I have to look at both sides of the coin. But generally, for me, I would speak on the individual. Which camera am I looking at? Camera one, camera two? Oh,
camera
yes.
Four.
Yeah, camera four. I would like to speak to the individual that is watching this and is interested in doing this long term. I would say, first of all, congratulations, because you have made up your mind. Then I would say, learn as much as you can. Don't let your ignorance be your downfall. Learn from the greats, even the ones you don't like. We have some amazing directors in the country, and we have some amazing directors outside of the country. We have some amazing, like the top 100 films. Watch all of them. And believe in yourself, and be consistent, and have patience. Then something will happen. I guarantee you something will happen.
Something will happen.
Yeah.
I like that. Social media handle so that we can live with your Diani holiday feature, because now people were in the planes and stuff. Anyway,
yeah. You could find me at Sunday Lyon. Mm-hmm. It's Sunday_LYON on Instagram. Yeah.
You can find at Black Ink Films on Instagram. And my handle is the_Wamboy.
The Wamboy?
Yeah, the_Wamboy.